Hey everyone, welcome back to Ocarina of Time. We're now in the royal family's tomb. We're gonna go get the sun sun now.
Our hero, ladies and gentlemen, desecrating the graves of the dead.
Well, it's not like they have anything to say about it.
Yeah, they're dead.
Yeah, well, there are ghosts in this world. I don't think that Link would want to be haunted for the rest of his life.
They're not ghosts, they're pose.
To say something that, to slip into slightly serious territory for a bit here, I never understood why grave robbing was considered such a crime. I mean, outside of civilizations like Egypt, where they believed in, like, heavy-duty afterlife shit and stuff.
I think it's just sort of a respect for the dead thing that comes from pretty much all religions. It's just one of those things where it's just like, I think it's just a universal idea that messing with a dead body isn't cool.
I'm not talking about messing with a dead body.
Screw your redeads. I'll take
the necrophilia and stuff. That's disgusting. But,
oh god damn it! Run away.
But I'm talking about like stealing jewelry from a grave. Tomb or whatever. I mean, like, it's not like the dead people are using it.
Hey, man, that's my hat. Give it back.
That's my magical fire sword. I was going to use that.
We just want the hat back.
Which song is this?
The Sun Song.
Ah.
By the legendary composer brothers, who we'll be meeting next game.
Smells like teen spirit. Sounds catchy.
Why would the Sun Song be down here, in the dankest, darkest place in town?
It just is.
You'd think it would be in some place like a sun temple or a lighthouse, like the sun glyph from Soul Reaver was.
Well, it's not. Now, this has two purposes. One, it speeds up time so you can warp to day and night whenever you want, and it stuns redeads.
For some reason. You kind of have to figure out that it stuns redeads on your own, though.
So, logically, if you could play the Sun Song over and over and over again for, like, 5 years worth of days and nights, would you grow up?
No, because the moon will already crash at that point.
Oh, Lewis, the rising of the sun doesn't actually affect time. It just affects the rising of the sun. If the Earth spin around the sun faster, we'd still grow at the same rate.
So, wait. This song makes Earth's rotation speed, like, go really fast, and then snap back to normal speed?
Sure, why not?
Yes.
So why hasn't everyone's neck snapped from pure whiplash yet?
Because that's not how gravity works. Why hasn't anybody been flung off to outer space?
And had their neck snapped.
That's what Pinky and the Brain taught me. I also don't get how we get out of these places.
Yeah,
are we
just
like
do.
Oh,
magic?
Well, I mean,
it's
we've
it's
got
magic.
The
magic. Ooh. Magic. Ooh.
It's like, okay,
with Lindsay.
Just standing in town. Next second, the Earth's rotation speed speeds up and the building next to you just rams into your face.
Or you could just use it to mess with people, I guess.
Yeah, think about it. It could also it could save on the fuel economy.
Yeah, it could. Oh god damn it, redeads, get away. Oh god
oh,
damn
god.
It.
Oh god.
Oh god, you're naked.
I thought this game was rated E for everyone.
No, it's rated teen.
Necrophilia in reverse.
No, this game's rated E for everyone. I'm almost positive. Now I need to check.
I think Twilight Princess was the only one that was rated T.
Yeah, maybe.
I think, though. I'm not fucking...
Actually, at this point, it was probably kids to adults. No, probably. It's E for everyone.
Okay, where's my heart piece?
Maybe it flew out of the room because you've been,
Where's my heart piece?
Yes, Twilight Princess is rated T for teen.
Okay.
So you didn't
Isn't
get
Skyward
the
Sword rated T for teen, too?
Yeah, I don't know. I don't care.
Give me one second.
Alright, okay, we'll go back and get that later. I'm going to this grave first, because it gives you a free Helion shield instead of having to buy it for 80 rupees yourself.
Yep. Is there any way to lose this shield, by the way?
Like likes.
Ah, yes, gelatinous cubes.
We're not supposed to get the mirror shield yet. But I can see my reflection in it just fine.
Shiny.
Skyward Sword is rated E10, which might as well be teen.
Yeah. Of course, when you're a kid, you're too scrawny to actually lift the Helion shield, so you just basically turtle up underneath it.
It's still useful, don't get me wrong.
Yeah.
It's not like there's too much. Besides reflecting things, there's no real difference.
It's basically something you only get at this point in preparation for Link's adult adventures.
You can still use it for a few things like climbing Death Mountain and its eruptions.
Yeah, but you're going to be switching back to the Deku Shield a lot.
Eventually. You don't want to use it for Dodongo's Cavern because there's a lot of fire there and your wood shield can burn.
Yeah.
Something that actually just completely dropped off with Majora's Mask, because Majora's Mask, the Hylian Shield, functioned just like the wood shield, only it didn't break or catch on fire.
Oh, that's right.
Takes place a few years after.
Yeah, I was about to say, the reasoning is that Link's a few years older and can actually use it.
That's right.
Has it been a few years?
I forgot that you couldn't.
That's what they say it is.
You couldn't raid the graveyard during the day. I forgot about that.
Let's wait at night
when the ghosts are going to be restless to take their stuff.
Well, Dompe doesn't seem to care that
and
I'm robbing
graves. And if the ghosts fight, we will fight back.
With our tennis racket.
Yes, and bombs. And our bombs.
Okay, and now let's try killing this thing without using the Sun Song.
What?
Well, you're throwing seeds at it. I don't think it would kill the zombie. Because that's effectively what a redead is, right? It's just a zombie?
Exactly.
Another name for a zombie. It might as well be a zombie.
Oh, I see. The thing only activates when you get close enough to it.
You can still stun it from afar, which is odd, but... Stunned. Yeah.
What the hell?
No.
Okay, now, am I the only one who finds Link's grunts incredibly... Oh god, stop raping him!
It's a good thing we have a shield over our backside now.
Stun.
Ted, to answer your question that I know you're
going to ask... Why the hell did it work now?
Young Link's grunts and yells were only annoying in the Game Boy Advance version of Link to the Past.
Yeah.
What about a Minish Cap? They were there, too.
I haven't really played a Minish Cap.
Yeah, thank god it's dead. What do we get for doing this? A heart piece.
It's a good thing we went to that other grave and found this rape shield. Now...
You got a piece of heart.
Is there anything else we need in this particular area?
No, there are a few other things you can. There are a few other things you can get later on, but for now we're done here.
Are you going for everything besides the gold skull chillas?
No, all I'm getting are a few extra heart containers via heart pieces that are easy enough to get on the way, and the Bigoron sword.
I see.
Everything else I'm forgetting because fuck fishing.
But don't you love Big the Cat's storyline?
No.
I didn't even know Big the Cat had a plot.
He has to get Froggy.
Before Sonic Adventure 2, there was Ocarina of Time.
It's time to fish and chew bubblegum.
And I'm all out of fish.
Out of fish.
Why are we going back to Hyrule Field?
Well, because I need something. Because I'm a smartass and know exactly what I need, I'm going to get Saria Song now instead of going to Daruni and figuring out he's not happy.
Go back.
You don't need it right now, though. You do need it right now.
Yeah,
I'm sorry, I'm a dumbass.
I was about to say, I do need it right now. I could go all the way up, but I'm going to have to come back anyway.
There's a warp point in there.
I forget that. Well, I know it's there, I just forget the... I'm not going there right now. I'm going across the field to Lon Lon Ranch.
Is it technically supposed to be Lon Lon Ranch, or is it Ron Ron Ranch?
Lon Lon.
It's Lon Lon Ranch.
Good.
Okay, hold on, rocking the wiki.
Because Ron Ron Ranch would sound incredibly stupid.
Well, it's alliteration.
It alliterates, but it also reminds me of Harry Potter Book 6, which is never a good thing to remind me of.
I see.
I thought you were going for the horrible Japanese accent, but okay.
The whole
English thing. That's why I asked in the first place.
So here we are at Ron Ron Ranch. Is anyone prepared for failure?
Yay! Talon. Wasn't there a guy named Talon in Link's Awakening?
Yes.
They rename people all the time. It's almost like the world continuously gets resurrected, but just with a slightly different plot each time.
Talon was a bird creature, and if Talon was in Wind Waker at all, actually, Talon.
This is only the second. Oh, Johnny, I found the second Talon. Then. We only need to find one more.
I don't get it.
Metroid Prime?
Oh, is that what you were referencing?
How it's spelled with two L's. It fails.
Close enough!
Find the three magic cuckoos, which are indistinguishable from the other ones.
Fucking hate
it. Well, you can watch where they're coming from.
Yeah, generally.
You have the camera facing the completely wrong way to do that, though.
I don't... Because there have been plenty of times where I swear I try to keep my best eye on the cuckoos he throws, and I pick it up thinking, yeah, this is definitely the right one. Nope, that's not it.
Yeah.
What do you get for doing this minigame again?
You get a bottle full of milk.
Not
a bottle full of milk.
You
get a tennis racket full of milk.
What?
You'll see. Much later. Chicken?
How long does this take you?
Chicken? Oh, god damn it. Fuck you, you fat ass.
Is he telling you to suck it?
Yeah, so let's try this
that
again.
That chicken's in a very awkward place.
Oh, god damn it. That was a really bad camera angle.
One of them landed right next to you, but the camera jerked around so much that even I lost track of where it was.
Okay, so that's one of them.
I find that the camera's a little bit uncooperative in this game. Not, like, too much that it wrecks the game, but it can be
a
little
places,
bit
yes.
stiff.
The best way to do this, though, is to have the camera facing Talon's back.
Yeah.
That way you can see where the cuckoos land when you start the mission.
Yep, but I don't do that for whatever reason. God damn it, I've already lost.
You're overconfident.
Yeah, you know...
There's another one. Yeah, let's try this again.
You know, I'm disappointed, Ryan. Just when we thought we got the hang of editing, and you...
No, I'm...
There's one. Get it. Damn you.
The only reason I keep this in is because it's my only real failure of the game. So I figured you might as well laugh at me while you can.
Well, that's nice, but I'd rather just skip past this, because there's only so much we can say at, oh, you didn't find the chicken.
Well, I've given you the opportunity.
Contrary to popular belief, we don't look forward to making fun of you, or anybody for that matter.
Sure.
I don't know, you seem pretty happy in Zelda 1.
Well, because you were playing so badly.
We know that was going to be a disaster. The fuck? May I ask where that's from?
It's from a Skyward Sword animation. Yeah.
Milk.
And you drink, you can bring back the bottle and buy a refill. I don't care, I just want the tennis racket.
Congratulations, you can now grow 50 times your size.
You got a tennis racket full of milk. Congratulations.
So are you gonna learn Epona's song now?
Yeah, might as well, I'm here.
Can you?
Yeah, you can. As long as you have the fairy ocarina, you can get it.
All that, you can show her the ocarina.
No, you can. Oh, hi, Luigi. You're not Ingo.
Oh, you know what? I noticed the similarity to Mario, but I did not notice the similarity to Luigi here.
Look, he's in the fire
flower suit. I didn't notice the similarity to either once you until you guys brought it up earlier, but once I realized that Talon was supposed to be Mario, it kind of clicked to me that he was supposed to be Luigi there.
I think it's easily more recognizable with Talon because he's wearing the blue overalls with the red undershirt.
Yep.
Luigi, on the other hand, Ingo here, is wearing Luigi's fireflower outfit, suit. Which is not immediately recognizable.
Yeah. No, you can get a bonus song now. Oh, it's the fairy boy again.
My name is Link.
Dumbfuck.
Dumbfuck.
Kazoontite.
This is a horse. Yes, I can see that.
This is... Riding the horse was the only thing one of my friends would do. It's just like, okay, I don't get what the appeal... Why did everybody want a pony? What's the point of... I don't get the appeal of ponies. They're just ponies.
Okay, activate cutscene.
This is a little bit finicky.
Yeah. Another you have to talk to her again so she can play the song. There we go. Now it activates.
So how are you supposed to know that you can even get this song?
Actually, that's a good question. Because I was actually stuck here for a bit my first time. Because unlike my first playthroughs of, say, like Sunshine or...
yeah, I forgot exactly what I did to figure out.
Any other game I was probably playing in the early 2000s to mid-2000s. My first adventure with Ocarina of Time was with no guide.
Yeah. You learned to put in a song. Not that I can do much with it, but it's important to have for later. And since I'm here, might as well.
I mean, it's not like this is a necessary song for the game, but it's damn convenient, so... Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
It'd be nice for a little bit more direction there, I suppose.
Yep.
It's more convenient to be able to use it whenever you want than it was in Twilight Princess, where you have to find special grass to use it.
I don't know why. For some reason, I picture this iteration of Link. Things normal walking is side hopping. It's like,
why are you going the long way around?
No, there's a heart piece over here.
Powder toes by flying backwards. This is normal for Link.
He registered it with the Ministry just last week, so. Yeah.